are spread all over Kenya, in the all regions of Kenya, majority being found in Nyanza, followed by Nairobi and Rift Valley. And the role of these TB ambassadors of hope is to refer TB suspects to facilities for testing.
Pamoja TB Support Group is a group that was formed up in 2009 with former and current TB clients who are survivor and people affected or infected with tuberculosis in our community. The main aim for this group was to support others and empower them as they continue their day-to-day drug adherence. So when we came together, we had very more defaulters in the community. So we decided to reduce these defaulters by making them know that TB is not the end of life.
We had to decentralize the MDR-TB treatment. We started with two. When we first started treatment of MDR-TB in Kenya, one was Kenyatta, the other one was Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital. But we have since expanded to more than 61 sites. In that round five, it also included, for example, coming up with one of the facilities where MDR-TB patients were going to be treated. And you may be familiar that with the fact that Kenyatta has one facility which was developed for this particular purpose, using the funds which were from the Global Fund. TB patient who has HIV is no longer being sent to an HIV clinic to be put on ARTs. We treat the fellow there. And in the first half of 2011, these are shot up to 60%. And we know by the end of this year, we'll be around 70%. When we started tackling these things, we reduced the death rate from 14% to where we are now, 4%.
An ultra-modern laboratory has been set up in Nairobi to detect cases of multi-drug-resistant TB, MDR-TB, and advise on effective TB medication.
Since the year 2003, when we had around 723 cases, up to now, last year, that is 2010, we had 7,256 cases. At the end of this year, 2011, we may end up having 8,500 cases. So managing all these cases in this institution is also not easy, because we need to ensure that each patient actually receives the results that they require. There's no patient who comes to this facility that is charged.
When the Global Fund brought the microscope on board, it really helped us to identify more TB patients. At the moment, we have around 16 patients ever since the microscope has been brought on board.
These successes have also been made possible through technical and financial support from partners like the Capacity Project Kenya, through funds from USAID, support from UNAIDS, World Health Organization WHO, and the French Agency for Development, who supported the Ministry of Finance with international technical expertise.
The Ministry of Finance has been building the capacity of implementers from the national levels up to the district levels. And as a result, the implementation, the management of the Global Fund has really improved. We are continuing with the same training so that the country keeps this level of performance and also really move to the next and the highest level, which is exceed expectation. And from there, we are sure the country will be getting more Global Funds money.
All has been possible through governance and leadership offered by the Kenya Coordinating Mechanism, KCM, and the principal recipients, which are the Ministry of Finance for all the government components of the grants, Care Kenya, Kenya Red Cross, and AMREF Kenya for the non-state actors components of the grant.
The principal recipient receives and disperses money to sub-recipients who implement different activities geared towards disease elimination or reduction. One of its core mandates is to strengthen financial and management systems and procedures for various sub-recipients for better implementation. These sub-recipients are derived from non-governmental organizations, the private sector, faith-based organizations, and civil societies with experience in health matters.
Some of them are small, so you have to decide how much can they cover in terms of geographical coverage, but also in terms of the target. So, for example, we are trying to target to trace the estimate is from the Department of TB control in Kenya, about 46,000 defaulters, people who started TB treatment and never completed it. Because if those are not traced and treated, there's a chance that you could easily get what they're calling mild drug-resistant TB, which once it's spread in the community is very difficult to treat and also very expensive.
As for medical supplies, all Global Fund medical supplies are done through the Kenya Medical Supplies Agency, KEMSA.
The Kenya Medical Supplies Agency is a state corporation under the Ministry of Medical Services, charged with the responsibility of handling the medical logistics on behalf of the government of Kenya. And that means, therefore, that our mandate is to do all the procurement, the warehousing and distribution of those medical commodities and supplies on behalf of the government to all public health facilities. And by extension, we also handle the global fund commodities in the same way, from procurement, warehousing, and distribution. Since 2002, we have moved in excess of $182 million worth of commodities, the global fund commodities. HIV, AIDS takes the greater portion of it, followed by malaria, and TB takes the lesser bit of it.
The Ministry of Health, the Global Fund, and other partners have the ambitious objective of expanding HIV care and treatment services to reach universal access by 2013. This they do by offering antiretroviral treatment for free to all patients with AIDS who require ARVs.
An ART center provides antiretroviral therapy to children and adults living with HIV and AIDS, but also provides other services. All the services and the drugs that are offered at the Mbagathi Comprehensive Care Clinic are offered free of charge. With the help of Global Fund, we have quite a number of patients who came in very unwell with either stage 4 of HIV AIDS, with very bad debilitating opportunistic infections, who would not have improved it if they did not get antiretroviral therapy. But because of the help of Global Fund, we managed to put them on antiretroviral therapy, and now they're improving and doing very well.
We are talking about children being born who are free from HIV. And this is achievable if all pregnant mothers who are HIV positive receive antiretroviral therapy to ensure that children are born who are HIV negative.
The Global Fund, through NASCOP and other non-state actors, have also been providing food supplements to people living with HIV and AIDS, those with very low body masses and with low immunities.
Through Global Funds, we have support in the area of ARVs, in the areas of food supplements. We have been able to put 28,000 clients on ARVs, and amongst this clan, this year alone, we have had we've supported 166 clients with therapeutic feeding. This is a feeding that is given to those that are low in terms of feeding, and we've also been able to put about close to 4,000 clients on supplementary feeding.
Global Fund is also supporting appropriate record-keeping in all comprehensive care clinics countrywide. Through the fund, the necessary stationaries are supplied to all the clinics. The records help in following the history of people living with HIV/AIDS and their treatment records and the disbursement of ARVs to them. Such records have been helping Global Fund to consistently procure medication at appropriate time, and hence no gaps. Global Fund grants have for a decade been supporting establishment of numerous voluntary counseling and testing VCT centers all over the country. One such VCT is the Kenyatta National Hospital VCT Center that has been offering numerous anonymous counseling and testing, in which clients are only identified by a number given at the reception.
There are numerous counseling and HIV testing rooms. The Global Fund has been supporting the activities of the VCT facility that includes the rapid test carried out using two different types of kits whose results are highly specific and sensitive to HIV.
So we have been able to provide services within VCTs, within health facilities at home, and even what you call moonlight at night. So with the support from Global Fund and other partners, we have been able to train people and develop a system for quality assurance, which is very important. One, any Kenyan who goes for HIV test to be sure get the correct, accurate results.
Periodic monitoring, evaluation and reporting, M&E, on the success and challenges in fighting the three disease areas has been key. The Global Fund is a performance-based grant, and as such, the submission of timely progress update is vital for the country to receive subsequent disbursement.
A grant lasts 5 years. The first phase of the grant is the one which is signed between the principal recipient and the Global Fund. Because you are going to phase two of the grant, depends on the performance of phase one. So once the grant is signed between the principal recipient and the Global Fund, not all the money is sent to the country. Indeed, the Global Fund releases money in tranches. You get money for 2 quarters and a buffer of a quarter. Because after 6 months, which are now 2 quarters, you're supposed to report to the Global Fund on the progress made in achieving the targets.
Since 2002, Kenya has been getting successive funding from Global Fund due to successes in implementation and meeting crucial targets in disease burden reduction. Some of the Global Fund activities that have contributed to the numerous successes in the fight against HIV/AIDS, TB and malaria are training of community health workers for adult literacy, training writers on HIV/AIDS writing skills, production of videos on HIV/AIDS, conducting theatre workshops on HIV/AIDS, TB and malaria, production and procurement of counselling handbooks for school use, recruitment of regional core training team for the three diseases, and production of IEC material and training youth officers in productive health issues. It is common knowledge that in all cases in which national HIV, TB and malaria epidemics have been reversed, broad-based behavior changes were central to success. Over the years, Global Fund has invested in numerous assets all over the country. The assets have been the base for the achievements so far seen in making Kenya free of TB, malaria and HIV. The nature of these assets range from vehicles, motorcycles, research facilities, diagnostics equipment like microscopes and renovated laboratories.
So far, the 10-year Global Fund grant stay and support in Kenya is proving winning the war against HIV, TB and malaria is possible through the right interventions, with the right support, to the right persons.